So it has come to my attention that there is a maintenance step on a latex printer that I didn't think about. Now, for the most part, I don't do any maintenance on a latex printer. The latex printer is self-maintaining. I leave for business for a trade show, come back in 2 weeks, printer prints just like I left it. I don't do anything. I could wear what I have on and run the latex printers every day of the week. Yeah, I don't get ink all over me. I don't have jugs of, you know, solvent ink that's all been purged out of the printer. I don't have any of that stuff. So, lo and behold, I didn't know there was this maintenance feature, but come to think about it, I guess it kind of makes sense. If you're running a lot of porous, fibrous material, let's take an example, the HP wall covering. It's a paper, a lot of non-wovens. Well, non-wovens are paper-based, and some of them have a nice textured surface to them. And if you're applying vacuum to them, what can happen is you're going to take little pieces of fiber, very, very small, and the vacuum, in trying to hold the material down, can pull that fiber. Well, there's little tiny vacuum holes all across here. Those little tiny vacuum holes have another little hole. And this hole is where there's little rubber gaskets, and this attaches and where the vacuum goes. So when these insert, this hole is sealed by a little rubber gasket, and it provides an excellent base for how the vacuum works. And then the vacuum pulls down these nozzles, the little vacuum holes. Well, certain materials, if you run a lot of it, allows that fiber to get down through these holes, and then it goes into the little vacuum gasket, and that can get filled with those fibers. In which case, you want to take this off, take a vacuum, put it on this hole and kind of suck it out. Generally, they're not going to clog these little holes. They're going to go down through here, and then they're going to clog up the little vacuum gaskets. But you can clean this out, make sure that these holes are open. With the ink collector, the issues in the past with printing on the platen, especially with getting ink on the platen, where you'd have to kind of punch these holes out, that's not really common on a 360, 370, 570, because you put the ink collector in. You might see a little bit on a 330 or a 310 if you were running some materials where a little bit of the ink got through the fabric and you'd have to keep the holes open, in which case just any sort of little jewelry punch or even a thin paper clip that can kind of open those up is fine. But the main thing is after you've cleaned this, you take a little vacuum. I use one that has a little, it's like a little computer vacuum. You know, it has like a little stalk on it. And then I just go down into these holes right here, which are on the underside of this, and then you'll see the fibers. They kind of build up there. And I just kind of go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 on this side and 5 on that side, and you're good to go. What will happen if you don't clean that out periodically, it'll compromise your vacuum, and then you're thinking, what's going on? I'm getting these head strikes because the material's not holding down. Well, your vacuum's been compromised because the holes are full of too much of the fiber, running a lot of non-wovens. Hat tip to a customer of mine that sent me notice about this and let me know, took a video of it. I hadn't seen this before, but it makes complete sense, and I checked mine, and sure enough, I had some fiber in mine too from some of the stuff I've run. So just a thing to note about cleaning the vacuum. It doesn't happen with many materials. You'll probably never see anything like that if you ran adhesive vinyl or banner all day. But certain fibrous materials, especially non-wovens, possibly some fabrics, that might happen over time.